What is up? This is Phase 23 coming at you with another Horizon Zero Dawn video. Today, I'll be doing a little bit of the Frozen Wilds gameplay. Now, after you make it up into the Frozen Wilds,
whatever's happening in Thunderstrum, it's not enough to bring down the
Banuk's name, the Flame. I don't know why it's so hard to pronounce or think. Scorcher. Okay, so after you defeat the Scorcher, you'll journey up the mountains a little more until you reach the this place, the Banuk. So looking at your map, let's see. So the Grave Horde right here, I actually haven't played it, the Grave Horde yet, but for some reason it won't let me in there. Anyways, after you make your way up the Grave Horde, if you do have the DLC, you'll continue to climb and you take the trail. The Scorcher, I want to say, is right around this area, because you have to climb up a little ways and then you finally get into an open area, and the Scorcher will probably be this area right here. So after you defeat it, you'll come into here, which is the starting of the Frozen Wilds. I'm gonna turn on all the... Anyways. You'll get into the control towers later, but basically, you can override them. They're part of the PSI override, so pretty much as soon as you start this, you can override them. But anyways, what they do, they kind of heal the machines and give them shock damage control or whatever that helps them avoid shock. So anyways, your best bet, if you want to override them, it'll shock all the machines in the surrounding area. And yeah, that'll do it. Also, in the Frozen Wilds, there is something known as Blue Gleam. It's kind of what you want to need or want to get if you want to get some cool weapons like my Champion Bow, Striker Bow, and Power Shot Bow. They're pretty high-powered bows. Probably really good if you want to get them. Anyways, if you want to find the Blue Gleam, you won't find the Blue Gleam on the map when you start out. But anyways, once you get the map, it'll look like this. There are around maybe like 32 to 36 Blue Gleams scattered around the map. There are a whole bunch more scattered in closer in this area, but then as you get further out, there's not as much. And anyways, that is something I suggest you get, because that'll give you a really good advantage against the machines here. Anyways, to get that, you go up to this guy. As he can see, he has no more weapons because I bought all his weapons. But anyways, what you want to do is go to special items, and there will be a map here that says Blue Gleam. You want to buy it. I forget what you need for it. You need like badger bone or goat bone, or I think it was goat skin and badger bone is what you need, plus the shards, and that'll get you that. And also there's all these. I might get a few more of those once I get some more Blue Gleam. Let's see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so I might get a few more of those. Of course, there's ammo. Try to make sure everything's good. So anyways, what I'm going to be doing today is I'm going to be setting off onto a mission right here. We're in all talks. So when you come in here, you'll want to talk to a few people. You'll go through a little bit of an intro into the Banuk land. A lot of people will be like, oh, what's Anora doing here? She won't last long up here. Anyways, what you want to do is, I usually go down this way, and when you go down this way, there will be a quest to do. It's clear all the way up here. The drone hangar. That's where you want to go for the quest. It'll give you a spear modification upgrade to where you can modify your spear, but this guy will give it to you. He'll kind of call you over. He'll be like, hey, Nora, person over here. So that's kind of what you want to do there. Get that. course, I don't really have anything good on my spear right now. It's like spear damage, just 14 spear damage. So, anyways, that's that. Also, one of the other missions, it's a Tallneck mission. Somewhere over there. Oh, right over there. But anyways, what you want to do there is you got to fight off some scavengers. Scavengers. Well, not scavengers. Sorry, I'm not really good with the machine's name. Scrapper. You got to fight off some scrappers and some Glint Hawks to get to the Tallneck, which is frozen in ice and offline. What you're going to want to do is you got to defeat those, and you got to locate the parts that are scattered around the area. That'll be in this area. The parts, there will be one that a Scorcher and a few Scrappers are guarding. I believe that's down here. They'll be inside a cave there. Another part, Flint Hawks and Scrappers up here, and then another part somewhere over there. So they're all three in this general location. And once you repair all the parts, the Tallneck will start walking again. There he is. And then you'll get a way out of all this area of the map. I haven't been over this way yet. I mean, I have. That's strictly Stalker territory, so I don't really go there because I hate Stalkers. It looks like there's something good right there, as far as I can see. I might travel up there later, but as for right now, just going to give you the gameplay of the Frozen Wilds. As we make our way to Naltuk, the shaman in training after the... Oh, I'll kind of give you a breakdown.
That must be Naltuk, looking out of that
tower. So the breakdown of it is there's something happening, and their shaman disappeared, and this is... you got to try to find her. Basically what it is.
Naltuk?
Who are you? How did you find me?
Burgrund told me you'd be out here.
He's persistent. I've told that Osteram 1,000 times. I don't need to buy anything.
And
so
I'm
this
not
guy
selling.
Is the shaman.
I just need to find Araya.
Well, you won't.
And you're trying to find Araya.
She's gone where only shamans can tread. She seeks guidance from the voice in the blue light. That is her task. And the task she gave me is to observe the daemon's work.
And then you get stop your demonic machines that are stronger and more powerful than the other
what
machines, even stronger than the corrupted machines.
In only a few weeks, they've sprouted throughout the cut.
And there's a tower that I was telling you about.
Pulses from them, rallies the machines, even repairs them.
Aratok said this daemon was frenzying machines.
Look there. Those with the purple markings. They belong to the daemon. They're stronger. More dangerous.
I've seen something like this before. A corruption. But it wasn't from your daemon.
You have? Then you know more than I do. Are these towers, were they part of your corruption?
No. Those are new to me, too.
Like I said, they empower the daemon's machines.
My outfit, so
they must
get
be stopped.
Will you tell me where Araya went?
You ask a lot of questions.
Only when I'm not getting the answers I need.
There's but one voice Araya wants to hear right now, and it isn't yours. I'm sorry.
All right. You want to stop the spread of the daemon's work? I know how to get started. With my bow and spear.
Outlander, wait. Won't you tell me your name?
Aloy.
Good. If you fall to the daemon's machines, at least I can properly recount your efforts to Araya.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. But I won't fall. And when I'm done, you're gonna tell me where she is.
Alright. Okay. Give me a second, I wanna change my outfit. Let's see. Trailblazer outfit. We're doing a storm. Alright, I'll do a trailblazer. Give me a shot.
Who? Me? Seems I can take care of the machines and towers. The Daemon's next.
You claimed its power for yourself somehow. Perhaps Aurea should meet you after all. What she truly seeks is hope. After what I just saw, you could show her that. She's in retreat beyond those mountains, the ice rasps. You'll have to walk the shaman's path to get there. You'll know you've reached the end when you come to a shrine, a great machine covered in blue gleam. Shamans who complete the path take a piece of it as reward. If you make it that far, you should too. You'll have earned it.
You said something about blue gleam at the end of the shaman's path?
A crystal that builds on the bodies of machines in the oldest ice. We Banuk believe it's the stuff of the blue light, frozen as it escapes their shells. You might be more interested that merchants will trade well for it.
Bergrin told me you're Araya's apprentice.
In her absence, I serve the chieftain and his werak as an advisor, a scout, a speaker for the blue light.
A lot of responsibilities.
I don't know if I can live up to Araya's example, but I have to try. I owe her that much. She took a chance on me. An aspiring shaman from the edge of the world. No one else would.
Were you with Araya when they attacked the mountain?
I wish I had been, even with all that happened. I'm no warrior, though, so she bid me wait. When Araya and the chieftain returned, I saw them argue bitterly. I don't know what about exactly. Then she came to me, gave me my task, and left us.
How do I cross this shaman's path?
Go to the ice rasps. Then follow the markers through the ice caves and the waterfalls, and make the climb to the shrine. But be careful. The path is meant to be an ordeal, the final trial of a young shaman's training.
And I'll find Araya at the end of it?
No. She goes further up, somewhere inside the mountain. If you see her, would you tell her... I have faith she will hear the voice again.
Alright, I guess
I'm off. So we have our new place to go, and it's right near Blue Gleam.
Ice rasps to find this shaman's path.
I was thinking there, I thought that guy was following me. I was like, oh, okay. Anyways, as we make our way up, hopefully we'll find it. Gotta be cold. Try to gather some supplies. Try to find some medicinal stuff. And of course, demonic snap moth. Deep in.
Good. I can use this.
Get some more supplies for arrow making. What you need, get the south rush as much as you can, because it'll bring up 15 health. I'll show you some of this on this.
I can get out of this.
I have anything I need. Wire. Alright, that'll do. Alright, as we make our way up the trail. Well, just to let you know, this river comes from a dam up that way. Right here, the Gray Catch is what they call it. Another tower. There's one tower there, but I got control of it. So now it's just that tower that I have to get. There's just too many of them there to go in. You'd almost need help to do that. There's snap moss, scrappers, you name it, it's over that one. Apparently I missed the path. There it is.
I could forget what warmth
feels
like out here.
Alright, as we make our way up the mountain. I actually almost came up here one time. I have not been up here yet. I was looking for blue gleam and I'm like, oh, there might be some up here, so. Almost came up here one time. Try to check the map as often as I can to make sure I'm heading in the right direction. It's gotta be cold. Almost there. Looks like there's a path I have to climb up. Man, that's just high up. Yeah, I was gonna climb it when I was gonna go get the thunder jaw. I was like, eh, I wanna climb up here real quick. Where's the campfire? It's right in front of me. Save game real quick. Where am I going here?
I'm pretty far up. The shaman's path must be. This must be one of the markers Neltuk told me about.
See what it does.
Looks like each marker points to another, giving directions. Guess I'm heading deeper into the cold, creepy ice cave.
Cold, creepy ice caves, right.
What's this chime for? To help guide the way with sound? If there's more, maybe my focus can find them.
Stuck.
Better go back after I grab this loot.
You read my mind. Yeah, what I'm gonna try to do with this stalker.
Just
like
way.
There's only one. Oh good, I need some more echo shells. Apparently I missed where I was supposed to go in it. Now I'm lost. Thank you. figure it out.
Dead end. But at least there's stuff.
Yeah. So it has to be able to fly. Oh, here we go.
Yep, focus can pick up the chimes. Should help me find my way.
There we go, guys, we found it. Took a little bit of a backtrack, but... looks like we need to get over to here, and I have a feeling we'll have to go up against the stalker.
Another marker. Good.
All right.
Okay, that weapon.
Stalker. As much as I can.
Wait. Back?
See what she did there.
The chime. Not sure I saw this fork before.
I didn't.
Up.
They're always trying to confuse you. Stay out of the stalker's line of sight.
a way out. Some gear, though.
No, yeah, definitely use some help. Interesting. Alright. Where to go from here? Suppose down here.
Done with the cave. So what's next on this one?
Well then, look at that. Oh, we had a fast track. That's great. It's like a waterfall.
Across this one. Down. Down it is.
Where's the I don't know if you realize this or not, but there are collectibles that you can get, and one of them is pigments. There's also animal figurines.
Pull the rope to move this thing into position.
Yeah. Just be on the lookout for collectibles.
We're just filling up.
Yeah, guys, this is my first time really playing the Frozen Wilds. I've just been focused on my weapons, not really anything else. So, yeah, this is all new to me.
Exaggerating. There's definitely something new out here, and I don't think it's friendly.
No, of course it's not friendly. Even once I get my Epsilon override, then it would be friendly. Dang it, it went away. I couldn't scan it. I do think I'm gonna have to fight one of those once I get to the end. I believe that's what I have to do. Where exactly is this game? Because I know you have to fight it on your way to fight Araya. Oh, come on. Save. Yeah, this is exactly where you fight it.
Reaching that tower to override it.
Oh, what you want to do? I was watching somebody earlier.
I guess we're doing this.
Got a demonic frostbite. Ooh, spear damage. Definitely want all those.
I've got a climb.
Skills 3, let's see, which one did I want? I want spear damage, since I do use spear damage when taking down. Now I wanted a strong strike. Alright, strong strike. So now that I've done that, we want to move on to go find Araya. I think the gameplay is just about over. And I think that was the last thing you really needed to get. And then, of course, get some stuff.
I should be able to get up there.
Alright. No idea where I'm going. So further up the mountain. I'm glad I upgraded my health, because that would have been bad. Alright. As we make our way up the mountain. That's risky. But hey, she's a good climber, so what's to worry about? That would be bad if I just, like, fell right there.
This must be the shrine Naltuk was talking about.
Oh, look at that.
Guess I should take some blue gleam.
Yeah. Oh, maybe. Yeah, I wonder what the blue gloom is, actually. Like...
Naltuk said Aurea went past the shrine, up into the mountain. I'd better take those stairs.
Alright, let's see. Wait, how did you know they were stairs? This was past human... civilization, would they even know?
An ancient door. Maybe Aurea's inside.
Maybe. Or maybe I just opened a can of worms. Alright. Recrafts and weapons. All in all, that boss ball wasn't that difficult. It's about the same as a thunder drum, really. Maybe a little less. Let's listen to this audio log.
March 10th, 2046. I just spent 16 hours in here trying to install upgrades to improve efficiency for the central processing unit. Project Firebreak is going to need the brain power. Let's just hope I'll have enough of my own. Anita stayed with me the whole time. We got a lot done, but every time she brushed by and I smelled her hair, oh boy, I should just go to bed.
Yeah, it probably sounds like it, dude. She probably go to bed. Might help us all.
Looks like the door's wired to something over here.
Power cable.
Locked. Maybe my focus can help.
Yeah, let's see, what can I uncover? I always love it, exploring these places. There's something right there. Well, maybe not. Thought there was, but apparently there's nothing more.
How am I going to explain to Kenny that Firebreak is doomed without a guiding intelligence advanced enough not only to think, but to feel?
Well, looks like we found it. Maybe. Rotate tree. Well, I don't see how I'm supposed to get to it.
Check the area with my focus, maybe.
What do you think I'm doing? Supposed to activate it if you can't even get into it. Huh. Yeah, this might help just a little bit. Another audio data core.
This is Director of Security Blevins resending the emergency supply order. Try reading it this time, okay? You weasels don't want me calling my people in SLC.
Oh, that guy's a jackass. Whenever I hear his voice, I'm like, seriously? What is wrong with you?
Director of Security Blevins is riding us like a petty tyrant. I can't even sneeze without triggering his control issues.
I could check my focus, see what it sees. Those nodes on the floor must be connected to the door.
Alright, let's see what I can do here.
Something. What am I supposed to do with these lights?
Alright. Turn clockwise.
These things turn, changing the flow of light.
Turn clockwise. Clockwise.
All right. Let's see if the door's open.
Well, I know something happened. I just gotta figure out what happened. Okay, where did I come in at? Oh, right there. Well, not bad. It's only been about an hour, which I spent about the first 5 or so minutes rambling on about. But either way, still pretty good. An hour of gameplay. Open the door. See what lies beyond.
Use my focus to look around.
Yes, yes, you could. Oh, just drop already. Yeah, that one might be a little bit more better to climb up. Alright, so as we make our way to the top, hopefully we will find Araya. Pretty nice place. Fun to go exploring. Also, over the summer, I'm gonna try to do like an urban exploration channel. I'm gonna add some of those videos, so if you want to stick around for that, just figured I'd put that out, because it's not just a gaming channel, it's channel to do a whole bunch. So yes, you will see me and a few of my friends exploring old abandoned places.
Out again. Maybe I can get back inside through that structure over there.
So yeah, hopefully we'll come to you soon. We are planning on doing it over the summer, so come at you with
like
a little more.
I need to get to those stairs.
Mean a ladder? Not stairs. Well, I guess those stairs. Save the game real quick here. It's like a mountain fortress, guys. Thought that was a supply crate, but I think. It also makes you wonder what happened, like, the whole backstory, like, of what happened. I'm sure it's explained, but
Maria must be close.
As for me, I do not know what happened.
She has to be in here somewhere.
Alright, let's see. Well, unless the stalker got her. Let's see if I can find anything. Nothing really. Assume it wants me to go through here. Gotta be careful I don't run into anything. Shield integrity. Alright, see what I find.
I ask again, as I've asked 1,000 times. Speak to me.
There's Araya.
What more would you have me do? Is there no prayer that will reach you? No mark that will break your bonds? Ah! I can't help you if you won't speak! A whisper is all I ask. To guide me.
She's like, what are you doing here?
No. How? How did you get here? The way was sealed by the spirit herself.
I used one of these. I could show you.
Yes, show me. Please.
Show me. Let's see what it wants me to do.
I'll bet the goal's the same. Get the light back to the source.
This might take a while. Turn counterclockwise this way. Turn it this way. It needs to go all the way around. Turn it this way. There we go.
Auxiliary channel recovered. Exploit successful. Restraints evaded.
Hey, there we go.
Is someone there? Ick Araya? Araya, I need you.
Authorized physician, return to schedule task.
No, I will not submit. Araya, the daemon is forcing you. Araya, please.
Transmission.
brought the spirit's voice back.
Well, looks like
you heard it.
Quite as done as I thought.
The voice of the spirit calling to me from the heights of Thunder's Drum.
Something.
She was able to throw off the bonds of the daemon for a moment. Because of what you did.
Daemon.
Who are you? And what do you want?
I'm Aloy. Neltuk sent me. He thought that you could use my help.
He was not mistaken. You've been a...
Revelation.
Revelation. Now I know for certain that the spirit endures. Perhaps together we can find a way to set her free.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I came all this way for answers, and so far, I haven't heard any.
It seems to me that you are the answer. But of course, I'll tell you all I can.
Alright, let's see. Spirit.
You seem to have a history with this voice. This... spirit.
She saved my life. Here, years ago, during the war with the Karja. A raid scattered my Werak. I was cut off, alone. I lured the enemy into the Rime Drifts, hoping to lose them in the mist, but they endured, so...
Give me a second.
I took refuge in this cave. That's when I heard a voice. Wanderer. Lost, like me. A spirit of the blue light, yet sundered from it. She asked me for aid. She chose me. But I was in no position to help, not with the Karja after me. So she helped me first. By closing a door on the mountain below, one you must have opened to get here. Locked by means similar to those found in this room. It kept the Karja from reaching me. Safe from them. I was able to do as she asked.
What did the spirit want from you?
She said she was hurt. Incomplete. She needed bones. Parts not unlike what you'd find in a machine. They were here. In this room. She wanted me to bring them to Thunder's Drum. So I did. And she showed me how to heal her. So began our communion.
You had a communion with the spirit?
Yes. Inside Thunder's Drum is a room like this one, only larger, with an altar. I went there many times to speak with her.
What did she say?
She told me she was lost and needed my help. She asked questions about our lands, our tribe. And she listened. With patience. With wisdom. I told her things long kept silent about my family, my dreams, my fears. She never tired of me. Never judged. We kept each other's company.
Aurea, what do you think the spirit is?
I see. You are not Banuk, and our songs are not familiar to you. You do not know of the blue light. That which struggles to survive in our hearts and animates the machines. The essence of life, and in its purest form. Harmony. As the anger of the machines grows, this light has faded from the world. And the spirits it sustains are stranded. That's what she is. A lost soul. Cut off from what it needs. Lonely. Forsaken. I must help her.
I like her helmet. Like, that's
we
a cool helmet.
Must.
I'm not sure if I understand. But I want to.
That's all I need.
Alright. What about
the daemon? What do you know about it?
I spoke with the spirit many times. First here, then inside Thunder's Drum. The last time. She told me she was under attack by something that could not be seen by mortal eyes. Something evil. She named it the daemon. And said it needed her power to do what it willed. And she begged me for help. To find a way to destroy her, if necessary, to keep it from using her. That was 5 years ago. I didn't hear her voice again. Until today.
The last time.
What kept you from the spirit, after it begged for help?
I went to Artok, hoping he could protect her. But the war with the Karja still raged, and before I could reach him... I was ambushed by the Mad Sun King's Kestrels, and taken to Meridian in chains. I wasn't able to return to Thunder's Drum until long after the liberation. Not until last thaw.
You said you returned to Thunder's Drum. That was the expedition that went bad. I saw the funeral.
Yes. Once there was finally peace with the Karja, Aratak and I gathered a warrack of great hunters to defeat the Daemon. And yet, the old door to Thunder's Drum was gone, replaced by a gate we could not pass, and many machines. We were crushed. Aratak called a retreat, but we had already lost our best. We abandoned them to the snow as we fell back. After, he and I could not agree on what to do next. So I came here, hoping against hope to hear the spirit again. And because of you, I did.
All right.
Let's see if I've got this straight. We heard two voices. One you call the spirit, captured somehow by the one you call a Daemon. Whatever this Daemon is, it's related to the machines and why they've become more dangerous. I want to know how. Both the spirit and the Daemon are on a mountain, Thunder's Drum. So why don't we go there and figure out what it all means?
We can't. Thunder's Drum is dangerous, more than you can imagine. The Daemon has secured it.
Too dangerous?
Besides, Aratak won't let us go. As chieftain, he controls the pass to the mountain, and he can't be reasoned with.
Sounds like you need a new chieftain.
Huh. There's an idea that's certain to win us friends. You said you were a hunter, and I'll wager you're not an ordinary one.
Of course not.
It's not impossible, even for an outlander. An Aratak couldn't refuse the challenge if you were known among the Werak.
Wait, me? Challenge Aratak? I don't want to be chieftain of anything, much less a bunch of Banuk that don't want me.
But you want to go to Thunder's Drum, don't you? You heard the spirit. She's suffering, tormented by the Daemon. She longs to be free. And perhaps, when released from her bonds, she can give you the answers you seek.
I can't believe I'm agreeing to this. Fine. What do I have to do?
Get the Werak's attention to show the worth of your claim. Win at the hunting grounds. Kill bandits that prey on the cut. Or speak to my friend, Sikuli. You help her, you'll definitely get noticed. Do all you can. When the time comes for you to throw your spear at Aratak's feet, I will be there to back your claim. Until then, I'll be here to answer any questions you have about the challenge. Oh, and one more thing. In the box over there is a weapon, like my own. Take it. You may find it useful.
Yeah, maybe. Storm Slinger. Let's see what this thing is. Resource. Disassemble. Don't really use stealth. Place the rope caster. I can upgrade carrier capacity. Alright. Ammo. Let's see what this can do. Modify weapons. Selective type. So, heavy line shot. Right. Let's get out of this place.
feel my...
Take out the bandits at that fort. Go ahead and fast travel. I'm hoping to complete this, but I don't know. I'll try to see if I can get it done, but I might have to do two separate videos depending on how time goes. So, yeah, just depends really. Around 3:40 in the afternoon, so I still got some time. Take out the bandits. Well, not really any other bandits in the area. Got a chance if I get into the camp. I have no idea what that was. Yeah, something just scanned the area. We'll see.
Got one.
Get a few more of these.
Found me even though I'm hidden.
You're not really hidden. Oh, come on. There is no way you can go.
Let him run.
Point arrows don't really work. How about a precision arrow? There we go.
Whoa!
That shot knocked it off.
Come on.
Would send a different kind of message.
Send a terrible act.
That signal will bring in reinforcements if they set it off.
Something.
Get my health back up. Probably shouldn't have shot that arrow at it, because that might have called him in. Well, anyways, we'll try that again. I hate bandit camps. Won't worry much about those guys.
Bandits aren't subtle. Clearing them out would send a different kind of message.
made him white!
Alright. Let's try this again.
This'll ruin you!
That alarm will wake up the whole camp. And more besides.
Take them out. Probably sure. Stayed away.
Looks like I'm clear.
Oh, just slowly go up behind them. As soon as they see you, you shoot them in the face with a full force precision arrow. There's one way to do it. I think that's everyone except for the one guy over here. One guy up there, he's a warrior. Don't have to worry about the alarm. No, there's still a few more people. Oh no, there's a hell of a lot more.
Let's do this.
Looks like every one of them, so I think we got them all cleared out. Blast trap. Just my salt brush. Use our own route. Gonna be tough.
Smells peaceful. I hate peace. A lot of people die peacefully.
It's like he's got some blaze on him.
I got a feeling. Search the camp. Get out there, turn over every rock, see what comes crawling out.
Killing you!
There we go. Killed the bandit leader. And now I take the weapon, I guess.
The Asaram's fire weapon. Could come in handy.
Yeah, that could come in handy. Just took over the bandit camp. Now there's a trading post.
Won't be long before the Werek finds out I took out the bandit camp. In fact, I'll bet my name's...
Forge fire. I already got the Storm Slinger. Modified.
It's all over.
Triple shot.
Someone's edge.
I think... Forge fire. And don't need full skin. So crafting, carry capacity, what do I need? I need 5 Echo Shell. Here, this guy has any. Out just a bit, modify it. 44 damage.
Either strive for the best.
Oh yeah, that thing looks great.
Nope.
That's one of the things I need to do. Go to the hunting grounds, win. And then go to, I guess I go to Song's Edge. Yeah. Go to Song's Edge, use Astral Pack. Not bad. That guy was pretty good. Now I got a new weapon. And it just keeps coming. I'm always on the lookout for better weapons for when I go up against bigger threats. That weapon would come in handy going up against that boss blocker. Fire and ice damage. I think with the Fire Claw, if you shoot at its shoulder things like I did, it'll be infinite fire damage that'll just keep going. So that'll help out tremendously, but now that I got a new weapon, should be good. I'll test it out here soon. Might try to find something. Alright, so where exactly do I need to go? I think I need to go over there.
My people have been telling tales of your accomplishments.
What's that?
Seems you have taken a special interest in our stretch of snow, Outlander.
Yes. And apparently this is the only way I'll get to see all of it.
Is this a challenge?
The Werek.
You? This must be a joke.
It is not a joke, Eratok.
Ooh,
The Outlander's your pawn. And with you backing her claim, I have no choice but to accept. I expected better of you, sister.
It was you who forbid me from Thunder's drum, brother.
Brother and sister? This is a little more complicated than I thought.
No, it's simple. You will meet me at the Frost Figures, and I'll put a quick end to this mockery.
Ooh. Family tensions. Always lovely.
I suppose I owe you an explanation. Yeah.
I suppose you
do. I suppose you do. So why didn't you tell me that you and Aratak are siblings?
I thought I wouldn't have to. I'm surprised Aratak brought it up in front of a stranger. He must be very angry.
I'm the best, too.
I'm not always the best judge of
people.
I prefer the company of spirits. They're simply my own. I didn't want you to think of our pilgrimage as some sort of family squabble. It's much more important than that.
It's bold, I'll give you that. Going after your own brother.
He gave me no choice. He thinks I'm a child to be shoved to the back of the hunt. He would forbid me from my destiny. And yet, part of me did it knowing he would forgive me, eventually. He always
does. I'm wondering what that thing on her arm is. Like, is it...
Family drama aside, what's this challenge meant to be anyway?
You and Aratak will hunt machines at the Frost Figures. The victor will be the fastest. It won't be easy.
Nothing about this has been so far.
When you meet us at the starting point, I'll tell you more. It will be simpler to explain from the base of the hills.
Araya, it's not about who's related to who. I want to know what's inside Thunderstrom. The spirit, the daemon, and how it all connects to the machines.
Well, looks like we'll find out here soon.
If we're gonna go through with this, I need you to be straight with me.
I underestimated you. And Aratak. I won't make that mistake again.
See you at the Frost Figures, then.
So... trying to think my best plan of action. But look at that. Is that, like, embedded in our skin?
So, off to risk my life in order to take charge of a Banuk hunting band.
The Frost Figures.
That's what I always wanted.
I know.
Frost Figures, here I come.
Beware the machines.
Save the game real quick.
Whatever's happening in Thunder's Drum, it's not enough to bring down the Banuk.
No, you keep telling yourself that sometimes. Trust me. There's a lot more going on than you think. Well then, let's see. I have no idea exactly where I'm going. I was checking something out on my phone real quick. Well, I probably should have. Hang on. I need more wire for my precision arrows.
Saving these for the trail?
Become better hunters.
All right.
It's odd to see new machines.
Get back up here. Oh, just gonna go that way. The design and complexity of the nature of this game is just amazing. Like, it looks so real.
Some werics have settled in Stone Yield.
Yeah, I wanted to stock up.
We run into each other again. Fight.
Go up here.
Hey, on your hunt and in life, it's wise to step into the footprints of.
All right. Liar. There we go. See if that's enough. All right. Hard point. All right, let's go. Now that we got that over with, let's go see about the Frost figures.
We are fortunate that Araya favors the cool.
I know, hearing some of these conversations is just funny.
So much for being careful.
Well, you know I'm not careful. Wondered what that was. I was like, what is that? Alright, but anyways, let's get to the prop figures. Hopefully I don't run into anything. Truth is, I probably will. This is scrapper territory.
Frost figure should be just up there.
All right, let's get to the frost figures. Now I like the hard point arrows. You can easily take a walker down or launcher down in one
frost
hit.
Frost figures. Our attack on Araya must be close.
Outlander. I have prevailed over such challenges before, and fear none. But this one is foolish. You are not Banuk. You do not understand my responsibilities. I ask you, one hunter to another, withdraw.
Will you let us go to Thunderstrom?
You haven't seen what's up there, Outlander! I will not risk my sister's life again.
Then we better get on with this.
So be it! I will bury your insolent claim in the frozen ground!
Enough!
Man, he's feisty.
Let us begin!
Let's get this over with.
To hunt! To strive! That is the way of the Banuk and of the contest before you.
Yes, I understand that.
You will climb the frost figures from the east, Aratok from the west. Each trail wends its way through deadly machines. Hunters from the Werak will be posted along the way. They will hail you, calling out machines for you to slay. Your hunt will take you around the ridge to the center, where you must descend to the valley for your final kill.
It's probably each a thunderdrum or something.
After your prey has fallen, you must launch a beacon such as this, so that all our kin will see your progress. Kill machines, launch balloons. Got it. So, the first of us to launch the third balloon wins?
Well, yes. But as Challenger, your path to victory is harder. If even one of your beacons comes in after Aratox, he prevails.
You had your chance, Outlander.
Let's see if I can do it.
So did you.
The hunt begins on my mark. Now!
See what happens.
All right, gotta head up that mountain. Looks like there are a few ways to go up, and those rock paintings mark the path.
That's stupid, though, but you have to
okay,
get yours
go.
Up before him, because some people aren't as fast. Time to restart the challenge, guys, because for some reason I somehow landed and went the wrong way.
All right, gotta head up that mountain.
All right, let's try this again.
Looks like there are a few ways to go up, and those rock paintings mark the path.
Get up the mountain.
Okay, up we go.
Try to go as fast as can be. Maybe I should have went this way last. There we go. Found it. This is where I should have went last night.
Come on, Aloy. Time's wasting.
Alright. So, journeying up the mountain. From hardpoint arrows.
I seem to be on the right path.
Should grab the medicinal shower brush. But I didn't. So we'll try a little with that.
Almost to the top.
All right, Challenger. You need to take off the herd.
Inventory.
Below every machine. Climb the ridge and launch your balloon!
Hartog knows what he's doing. No time to waste.
Take the rappel point to the next challenge.
Two bellowbacks ahead, Challenger. Kill them both. None of the other machines matter.
All right, two dead bellowbacks. Yep.
Introduced.
close, but not close enough. Even with the sawtooth to help. That was close, but not close enough. Let's try that again. See if I can do it better.
Two bellowbacks ahead, Challenger. Kill them both. None of the other machines matter.
All right, two dead bellowbacks coming up.
Gathering under this small stuff.
Okay, no more sneaking. But only by a little. I gotta get moving.
All right.
Now take the zip line and work your way down to the valley.
Storm's kicking up. Can't see much.
Don't worry. We got this.
Close now. Almost down.
What do I have to face?
All right,
this time?
The last challenge.
Fireclaw.
Something's wrong. My kin should be here, driving in our final quarry.
Get that in. Hang on. I should use a rope caster, because that'll help us. Now that I don't have it. So close, guys. I almost got my health back up, but it just did not work out for me. Killed
him. Be prepared.
All right. idea. Inventory. Tripcaster. Let's see what I can do here. Use a couple of these freeze arrows to my advantage.
Feels like if I blink, my eyes will freeze shut.
My rope caster. See that? Was so close. Better not have to fight all of them again. And better just be this last one. Oh, you fucker. I see you. Hang on. Notebook. Frostclaw. fire. Shot to tear. Body is weakness to fire. So to start off, I wanna
thank you. charge a rope caster.
Frostclaws from Thunder's Drum.
The attack cut short the competition. Naturally, there can be no result. It is void.
Well then.
You saw what she did. She defeated the machines. Not I. It is proven. She is the better hunter.
Well,
you have Banuk. Survive, prevail. What else matters?
Oh, he just cut himself.
My blood is in your teeth. I take my place behind you on the hunt.
Well then.
No more well, hunters may make the ascent to Thunder's Drum. The way is closed to all but the chieftain and myself.
It is not my place, but I would ask a boon to accompany you and my sister.
It might be permitted, but only if you do as I say.
Sibling rivalry goes a tough way.
Only if you do as I say. Thunder's Drum awaits.
Well?
There's a camp at its base, Long Notch it's called. Huh. Meet us there when you're ready. Chieftain.
Apparently I'm a chieftain now. That was probably one of the hardest things I've ever had to do. Three frost claws at once.
Feels like if I blink, my eyes are...
See, got two skill points. Nothing I really want to do at the moment. Might get that one next.
And a weapon like Artox. I guess the chieftain gets the chieftain's gear. And now it's a Long Notch. Nothing left to keep Thunder's Drum.
Can't get the frost claw heart. Take some stuff out of my inventory. Disassemble all of this. I have enough chill water. No, yeah, definitely disassemble all this because that's definitely enough chill water. Parker. Disassemble some. Alright, so that should definitely clear out most of that. might have to clear out some modifications as well. Handling, disassemble that. 13 handling, because it's pretty high up there handling. Disassemble those corruption coils. Alright, that's ample. So this apparently is a frostball site. Stock up on resources. Open. Don't need any of that. Outfit weave. Nice rail. Alright. Apparently I am I'm a chieftain. Health recovery over time. Carry capacity. Upgrade. Modify my outfits. Resist melee. Resources, get rid of that. Weapons. It's 42. Definitely comes in handy. Handling coils. Need definitely that. Alright. Should have used that on my shadow cast. Alright, guys. So we're with, that's Fireclaw, I can tell. But anyways, let's do it. Well, that reminds me, I do want to try this or something. Going the wrong way. Go to Long Notch. Alright. I think we're gone. I think I might have a fast travel pack. No, I do not. I'm gonna have to go the long way. Definitely stock up on more materials. Search its health potions. I don't really need shock watch. Don't really need any resistance potion.
A quick way down.
Yes, indeed. Seeing that, I thought that was a stalker, and I was like, dang it, I have to go against one of those. Alright, so we'll go here and we'll save.
They know where I am.
Tries to shoot. Sounds like we're close to the tunnel. Be careful in this area, I do know. shouldn't be too much of a problem. Need more plants. More. Medicinal plants. Try to avoid around that area where the tower is, because that's stalker territory. Here, for any of you that don't know, I do like to save along the way, just so, in case I might have to die or restart, starting point close to where I was. On the way there, stocking up on resources, especially the medicinal kind. If we go up against something big up on the mountain, I'll have a lot of health at my expense. Well, anyway, here we are. We're heading up. Looks like we got something up there. What kind of machine? Shell Walker. I remember that from last time. I was up this way.
Bring this tower down.
Alright, guys, something's come up. I will have to leave for the moment. So I will have to close this video, but I'll pick it up here next time. So, from here on out, this is Phase 23 wishing you...